Atlantic City has, I guess, has figured pretty prominently with the group. You had those two long runs here over the couple of summers. So what did that mean for, you know, for you guys to sort of have that experience?
Oh, it's always great to come back to AC. You know, we had two good summer residencies there, one in 2010 and one in 2011. We had a lot of fun doing that, and, you know, we love coming back to AC, and we're excited to come back and perform two shows there at Cedar. So it's, it's really exciting for us.
And what was it like to be, you know, to be in one place for that long a period of time? Was it nice to sort of settle down, and, you know, especially in summer at the beach? How was that experience for you?
It was great, yeah. It was really nice. You know, we got to get off the road for a little bit and kind of have a sit-down for 3 months, which was nice. You know, we just could live in the hotel there and walk down to the show overnight and walk back to your room and could have your stuff in one place for about 3 months there. It was good. And then, of course, yeah, the Atlantic City and the beach scene is always really nice. We got to endure in a lot of that. So it was a lot of fun. We met a lot of cool people. And, it was cool to be in a sit-down place for 3 months. It was cool to do that. I'm glad we got the opportunity to do that.
And do you have to sort of change the show up a lot when you do something like that? Because people might be coming back to see you, or...
We changed the shows kind of specifically and made it for Atlantic City, so we kind of made it special for Atlantic City, where our usual show is about 90 minutes long, and then I think our Atlantic City shows were about 75.
Okay, yeah.
So it was a little bit shorter, and there wasn't an intermission or anything. It was just kind of wham-bam. So we kind of did this songs through the decades, both summers. We kind of did different songs, kind of starting with the 50s and kind of going up through today. So we kind of hit, you know, all the big genres of music and try to hit, you know, at least something that, you know, any age person would come to the show and see and like. The two shows this time will be our normal touring show, which is, you know, 90 minutes with an intermission. Of course, it's closer to holidays now, so we'll probably be doing a number of holiday selections as well.
And the audience for vocal music, is it, you know, what do you think is driving the appeal? Is there a big glee factor that people, you know, bringing in people to see you?
Yeah, well, it certainly helped. It certainly helped, for sure. You know, we kind of started to get going kind of right as that show was starting up as well. So we both kind of got into the kind of scene at the, kind of at the same time, and also the show that is no longer running the sing-off, which is an acapella show, kind of helped. Helped us as well. So, you know, it definitely helps us when, you know, vocal music and acapella and you know, singing harmonies is out there so people can understand it and recognize it. And when they, you know, come to a show and you know, at least are a little bit more educated in kind of what our kind of music is and all that stuff. So, yeah, it definitely helps.
And how did you get into this kind of music?
I kind of had always been, my family's very musical. My dad sang, my mom played the piano. I grew up always listening to kind of different vocal groups, you know, the Beach Boys and different acapella groups just kind of coming up. Then I kind of knew about acapella and then just kept on doing it in college, and now we're doing this, so it's been great.
And now you mentioned that, yeah, college, you were in the college version of this group, right, before you came to the professional level, is it?
Correct, yeah. We all were at Indiana University. That's where the group started.
Uh-huh.
Once the original guys graduated, they left the group there for guys to continue on. And there's still a group at Indiana University today that is our legacy group, and they're under a different name now. They're called Another Round. But every one of us in the group, the professional group now, had gone through the undergrad group at some point, just maybe not at the same time as everyone else.
And so when you came up from the college group to this group, what, you know, was there a big transition to be, you know, were you prepared to sort of, was it different to perform, you know, in different kinds of audiences, or what was that like for you?
Well, I had about a 2-year gap in between. I graduated from college. I sang on cruise ships for 2 years, and then I joined this group in the spring of 2009. So I had a little bit of professional experience, but I mean, was I prepared? Kind of. I mean, I knew how to sing acapella in college, but, you know, there's still kind of a learning curve of when you get into a group like this and perform for, you know, thousands of people every night. There's still a bit of a learning curve once you first get in. But I learned pretty quickly, and, you know, it's now, 4 years later or something. It's been going pretty well, so it's always good to improve.
And how much do you guys have to rehearse? Is there a lot of practicing behind the scenes, or do you, once things are set, are they just set, you know what you're doing? Or?
We usually try to bring in new music for every tour. And then while we're on tour, our sound check is kind of our rehearsal for the day. So we'll take, you know, an hour of sound check to learn a song or do a kind of polish up some song that maybe we've had some problems with the last couple of nights. And then that's kind of how we do it on tour. Usually before the tour, we'll get together a couple of days or a week before, or just meet all in the same city and kind of get together and learn that if there's a bunch of new songs coming in, we'll learn all of those and get those ready and get the choreography or whatever staging going for that. So, and we'll have a couple of days before the tour for that. So that's when we'll usually rehearse for that.
Mm-hmm. And you mentioned choreography. Is that does every song have a little choreography, or does it just depend on the song?
I would say not every song has choreography, but they all have staging. So we're not just standing there in a circle the entire time. But every
right.
song has some kind of movement. But
uh-huh.
obviously, some songs have more than others.
And is that how you guys sort of think of some things to do? Is it, does someone hear a song on the radio and think, oh, that could work for us, and sort of bring it to the group? Is it sort of organic like that, or?
It really depends. It kind of works in a bunch of different ways. Sometimes one guy will have an idea and just kind of go with it. Other times, people will hear something on the radio and say, hey, this would be kind of cool a cappella, or hey, this song would sound cool with this song, and we should put them, mesh them together. It kind of comes from different areas. Now, there are two or three primary arrangers in the group, myself included, Walter, mm-hmm. music director, Ryan, and a couple other guys do it too, but a lot of the guys that are kind of idea guys, they'll come to an arranger and say, hey, I have this idea, what do you think, blah, 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 and then we'll put it to music and teach to the group.
And you had mentioned also earlier about the university group having the same name, and I think that changed this year. Was that confusing for people that there were two Straight No Chasers out there in the world? Or?
Yeah, it was. We had been working together with the same name for about 3.5 years, and it was just getting confusing. People were confusing us with them, and them with us, and it just got to a point where we couldn't live, doing the same thing with them having the same name as us. So I think this beginning of this year, they changed their name to another round, and are doing great. So it's been a smooth transition, and everyone's been happy, and they're doing a great job at Indiana. We couldn't sell them fall, so they're doing a great job.
And now, do you have to do anything special to take care of your voice? I mean, it's not just your singing voice; it's also sort of the instrument. Since you guys are a cappella, so do you not talk on a certain day of the week, or do you what do you do?
Some guys are different than others. I know Jerome is a guy who will shut his voice down after a show or not talk a couple hours before the show, something like that. Personally, I just try to warm up really good before each show. I try to drink a lot of water, and I try to get as much rest as possible. That's really the main thing for keeping your voice healthy, is if you drink a lot of fluids and get a lot of rest. It's pretty simple, but unfortunately, we haven't had any problems with people going down with their voice going out or anything, so hopefully we can keep that going, because it's a big, big part of what we do.
Right, right. So looking ahead to 2013, are you doing like a full-length album, or do we have any big plans for the year?
We do. We are hopefully having our new full-length album coming out early next year. We haven't set a date yet, but hopefully early next year we're planning on coming out.
And Pete, what are there songs you'll be performing in Atlantic City that might be on the album? Or?
There are a few that may be on the album, yes. Without giving too much away, there may be a few that we perform in Atlantic City that will be on the album. I think a handful of them will be on the album, now that I think about it.
Uh-huh. And can we mention any of them? Or?
We can't.
Okay. Can we then just mention what some of the songs are really going to be performing in Atlantic City? I'll separate. I will just talk
sure.
about the, yeah. So what's on the set list?
Like I said, there's everything from... We do two songs by Fun at the beginning, which is two current songs. And then, we'll do an older, well, not really an older song, but one of our hits is I'm Yours by Jason Mraz. We always do that song.
Mm-hmm.
And then we also do, an older tune, Don't Let the Sun Go Down Me by Elton John. So, we do a lot of things that are just for everyone. So, of course,
right.
we do a holiday set as well that includes all the stuff from our selections from our first two holiday albums that we'll do. So actually, last year when we were in AC at Caesars, I jumped on stage for a song and I tore my ACL.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so hopefully that doesn't happen again. I actually had surgery in August, so I'm going to take it easy this time.
Ouch, yeah.
Yeah, with the Lady Gaga medley that we did last year.
All right, so blame it on Lady Gaga. Okay, great. Well, thanks for adding that little factoid, and thanks for talking.
Sure.
I appreciate it, Tyler.
All right, thank you.
All right, take care.